Hi, this is Bill Castle. I'm a professor emeritus, that means I'm retired, from the University of Florida. I have a background in horticulture, worked with the citrus industry for a long time, and I'm now in my office at the University of Florida facility, Citrus Research and Education Center in Lake Alfred, and we're going to taste some pomegranates. About a year before I retired, it was very apparent that citrus growers were interested in alternative crops, and we've been exploring pomegranates in Florida, and we have a project, and we have two collections now that consist of about 100 accessions, and they're about 3 years old each, and we're beginning to collect some fruit from them and get an idea about flavor and yield and so forth. So today, some fruit that was harvested just yesterday morning from our collection here at the Citrus Research and Education Center is on display here, and these are the fruit that we're going to take a little test of this morning and see what their characteristics are. Some of these are being harvested and tested for the first time, so we're excited about this. Okay, the first one that we're going to take a look at is called Al Syrenar, and it's obviously a bit of a small fruit but quite well colored for the hot humid summer of Florida, which is an important issue. Now, there are a number of ways in which people say fruit can be opened and the seeds extracted. One of the ways that I like to do it is simply to cut off both ends of the fruit and then score the fruit in several places and break apart the fruit and see what the seeds look like on the inside. So, Al Syrenar. Looking at this one, it's sort of pink, and relatively speaking, the side of the seeds and the fleshy outer part that's called the aril is rather large. And we've been using a scoring system for tasting as we are today. Actually, what I've done is ask people to take a red piece of paper if they dislike the fruit, a green piece if they really like the fruit, and a yellow piece of paper to indicate that, well, they're not quite sure about it. So today we're going to use that scoring system as well to evaluate each of these. Okay, so take a handful of these little guys. Flavor's pretty good. But I'm discarding the seeds because they're too hard to consume, I think. So, Al Syrenar. Small fruit, well colored. The seeds and the arils on the outside of the seed is nicely colored. Flavor is pleasant. Large arils, very nice and juicy. Okay, so we'll move on to the next one, see what we have. The big fruit in the center there is a fruit from Iran known as Azadi. Sometimes it's mispronounced as Azadi, but the correct pronunciation is Azadi. And this obviously is a large yellow fruit, which sort of flies in the face of the expectation for pomegranates. Most pomegranates that you see in the grocery store are a bit smaller than this, and they're red, and when you cut them open, they're red as well. This one is very different. This is a mature fruit. By the way, that's often an interesting question that's asked. How do you tell when a pomegranate is ripe? Well, if you look at this fruit, you'll notice that it's not quite so round anymore, that the sides have been a bit flattened, and that's the first indication that the fruit is approaching or is mature. So let's cut this one open and see what we have. Clearly, it's pink. Score the fruit. See what we have. Aha. So, a little bit different in color from the first one. It's more of a whitish to a very light pink in color. But this happens to be one of the ones that I think is the most promising for Florida. This one that's called Azadi. Lots of seeds. Taste a few of these. Very pleasant flavor and nothing to discard. The seeds are what's called soft, which means they can be consumed. By the way, there is also a little bit of confusion about the difference between a seed and an arrow. Okay? This little guy right here is a seed. And the arrow is actually the fleshy part that you consume on the outside. So it gets a little confusing. This whole thing is called a seed, and the arrow is one part of the seed. But it is the arrow that you consume. Okay, so I think we're going to give a green tag to this one, and with good justification. Lots and lots of wonderful seeds with a mild, pleasant flavor. This fruit certainly would have usefulness as a fresh fruit as well as a fruit for juice. Okay, so that is Azadi. Now we'll move on to the next one. I have room for all of this fruit. Okay, next on the list is this fruit, which is of a modest size, beginning some color development on the peel. This is one that's called Grenada. All right, let's see what we have here. First of all, let me mention one of the things that is important in all of this. If you notice on the bottom of the fruit, this part is called the crown. And this is some residual parts from the flower, that there's some brown discoloration here. And this is caused by a fungus called Botrysphaeria, and it is one of the major issues, I think, that's holding us back from commercial production right now. We're working on trying to resolve that. So this is something to be aware of and pay attention to. All right. Grenada. Nice peel, color development. But again, doesn't appear like there's very much internal color development on the seeds or the fleshy part of the arrow. In fact, these very much would be described as white seeds, sort of medium in size, and even different from the one that we just looked at, Azadi, you can see the difference between the two. One's very much white, another one's got a little pink coloration to it. All right, let's see how they taste. Tell you what, yellow for this one. This may be a very satisfactory fruit eventually, but right now it's a bit tart, I think perhaps a little immature. But it may have some potential. So, there we are. Reasonably well colored on the outside, medium to large size fruit, white seeds with white arrows, and a very tart taste. So, that's Grenada. Right. Next up is the one that's the best colored. Medium-sized fruit, as you can see. No blemishes to speak of on the fruit. Very nice color. This is a very good coloration beginning at the base of the crown, as it's called. And this is a fruit, a selection called Pomegranates. There we go, Pomegranates. Let's see what we have here. In this case, it appears that the color of the seeds and the arrows matches what we see on the outside. Look Look at that. Isn't that lovely? Very nice color. Not a deep red, mostly a sort of a light colored red. Not bad. Somewhere between the green and the yellow. Flavor is pretty good. Seeds are somewhere between soft and medium, which means that they're edible. Smaller size fruit to medium size fruit. Very nice colored seeds, and just about edible. Not exactly sweet tart flavor, not exactly a mild flavor, but edible at this point in time. So that is Pomegranates. This one is called Sweet. Ah, let's see if it actually is sweet. Okay. We'll open this fruit. Notice it's a fairly nice sized fruit. Fairly good pink to reddish coloration developing. But white seeds. Sweet. This one is called Sweet. This one, I believe, is also a soft-seeded variety. Look at that. Care to count how many seeds there are there? No, there's a bunch of them. Okay. Seeds are a little too hard for me. Flavor is coming along, but it's not very well developed. The flavor of this one is definitely not as good as the Azadi that we tasted at the beginning of this exercise. Okay, so maybe a yellow flag on this one. We have one called Soren, which is another Middle Eastern variety. Looks kind of interesting. Actually, several questions have come recently as to what the status is on this particular variety. Here's how you spell it. Soren. Again, a medium-sized fruit, not too bad in size, and fairly well-colored, anywhere from a sort of a light pink that's developing to a bit advanced color. Soren. Well, that piece is trying to get away there. Let's see what this guy looks like. Alright, not surprisingly, perhaps this is a late maturing variety and arrow color hasn't developed yet, even though the peel is developing some color, and that certainly is very evident again, because what do we have? We have white seeds. And seed size is relatively small. Very definitely hard seeds. I give this one a yellow because fruit size is good, peel color is developing nicely, but the seeds definitely don't have a very good flavor at this point in time. They're not quite ready for prime time. Here's one that looks kind of interesting that we're tasting for the first time, called Christina. I'm not sure whether this is a yellow fruit or not. This is a variety that came from a nursery actually in North Florida up in the Panhandle, and it is fairly popular. Sell a lot of plants out of this nursery. They go to that local area up there. I've never seen the fruit before. This is the first time. Let's see what it's like. Very possible that this may be an immature fruit. Small fruit, as you can see. Aha. This looks kind of interesting. Christina. large seeds. Very large seeds with a little bit of pink development in them, suggesting that perhaps with a little bit more time, with a little bit of cool weather, these will develop more color and perhaps more flavor. Well, flavor's pretty good. I'm going to give this one a green. Seeds are a little on the hard side, but the flavor is quite good. The flavor, I would say, is competitive with Azadi, which is the standard for comparison at this point in time, so this one's not bad. Okay, that's Christina. This is a selection called Sakurdzi. Small fruit, a little bit different shape, nice color development taking place, and let's see what the inside is like. In this case, is it going to match what we see? Ah, voila. Looks kind of interesting. Look at that. That's probably the best internal color we've seen among the collection that we've been looking at today. Small fruit, small seeds, and guess what? Whoa, that one is not ready for prime time, definitely. Good color, but it's going to take a while before this one is edible. It's very tart. So that's Sakurdzi. Okay, well, that pretty much wraps up the taste test. And let's take a look at the website now to end up this presentation. Okay. Hi, we've made a short journey from the table where we're doing the testing over to the computer in my office, and I wanted to show you the Pomegranate website. To get to that website, where a great deal of information is located, as well as previous taste test results and so forth, is all available at the University of Florida Research and Education Center, Citrus Research and Education Center website. So if you search for CREC, up will pop this website. And all you have to do is scroll down to Citrus Extension, click on that, and you'll find another place labeled Alternative Crops and Pomegranates, and up will come this website, Pomegranates for Now. There are announcements here. For example, we just had a small meeting in Kissimmee. There's a field day that we're having here in Florida on August 23rd up at Water Conserve 2, where we have one of the collections, and there is now a Florida Pomegranate Association, which came into being in Florida in March of this year, and will be having its first annual meeting here at the CREC, the Citrus Research and Education Center in Lake Alfred, on September 14th. Certainly, you're welcome to join this organization and participate in the meeting. In addition to announcements, there's a great deal of information here about botany and culture and health benefits. There's some information about starting a pomegranate enterprise, and there's even some information here about what might be the best pomegranates to start an enterprise with. By the way, one that I showed this morning, Azadi, the large yellow fruit, I think is very promising. Another one called Desertny, another one called Salavatsky, and Badovye Vasha are the four most promising ones, in my opinion, at this point. So, please contact me. My contact information is on the website, or visit the website and enjoy a pomegranate. Thank you.